COVID-19 continues to ravage communities across the country, including the Navajo Nation. Nearly 800 of its residents have died since March. And just this past weekend alone, another 200 new positive cases reported, causing an extension of a stay-at-home mandate. And the chief medical officer of the Navajo Area Indian Health Service is Dr. Loretta Christensen, and joins us now with more. Ma'am, thank you so much for being here with us. And people hear some of these numbers and compare to maybe some of the larger states and larger cities. They don't compare, but the Navajo Nation back in spring per capita had the highest infection rate than any U.S. state, and that rate is even higher now. What is it that's unique to the community there that's causing such a high rate?
Well, the impact of health disparities in Navajo has been very, very challenging during this COVID pandemic. We have a third of our homes across the nation that do not have running water, and many don't have electricity either. We have many of our families living in multi-generational homes, which makes social distancing virtually impossible. So we actually end up treating many of these homes not as a COVID positive patient, but as a COVID positive family. So where having your family together is usually a very positive experience, it places these families at great risk. Additionally, we have tried to ask people to go into isolation, and they don't have the funds to have 14 days of food and supplies. And we only have about 13 grocery stores across 27,000 square miles, which makes healing, healthy food not very accessible.
What about now vaccines? Vaccines are being rolled out across the country. So how is vaccine distribution going there? And are you encouraged that this is going to help once you do get it to the wider community?
We are actually so grateful to receive our shipment of vaccines. Our first shipment came into Gallup Indian Medical Center on 12/14, at which time our Navajo area distribution team picked up the vaccine, took four different routes, and redistributed across Navajo Nation. The following day, we had two more shipments, and again, two distribution teams with our Navajo Nation police escort took the vaccine to the remaining facilities. So we began giving vaccines actually that first day on 12/14. We now have a tangible weapon against COVID, and I believe that our healthcare workforce and our people now have hope again.
There are some communities, of course, communities of color in particular in this country, experience that, like you just mentioned, some health disparities and inequalities, and have expressed some resistance to taking the vaccine. Are you finding that in your community?
Not so far. We've been very fortunate. We've had a lot of people step up for the vaccination, and a lot more people calling and inquiring about appointments. We, of course, will have some that will decline, but largely everyone has been very positive, and they are enthusiastic about getting their vaccine at one of our healthcare facilities.
Lastly, what's your message to the community going forward now in this last stretch of the holidays? Like you said, there are just some things unique to Navajo Nation that make it almost impossible to separate people. So what is the message now going into the holidays and this the new year and this stretch and hoping to make it through?
Well, we have our vaccine now, which is a weapon against COVID, but we still have to wear our masks, watch our distance, and wash our hands. But we're very grateful for all the assistance and support we've had here in Navajo. My gratitude to my NAO team and all the healthcare workforce across Navajo. And we go into 2021 resolute. We will defeat COVID, and we will restore Hojo, which means balance and harmony, to all our people in Navajo.
That is a great message. Dr. Loretta Christensen, again, Chief Medical Officer of the Navajo Area Indian Health Service. Thank you so much for spending some time with us and giving us an update with when it's, we know it's a busy time for you. Thanks so much and Happy New Year to you.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Well, hey there, GMA fans, Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.